Hello students, now we are going to perform practical focal length of a convex lens by displacement method. It is also called as a Bessel method and it is also called as a conjugate foci method. For this, this is the illuminated object and this is the convex lens and this is the screen, this is our screen. At first, we have to find out approximate focal length of this convex lens. For that, see, there is a window. We have to focus this window on this screen by adjusting the distance. Now see, these are the parallel rays coming from the window are focused here. You can see window clearly. We have to find out focal length of this convex lens approximately. For that, make a marking of the convex lens here. Again, make a marking for the screen and this will be f, that is the focal approximate focal length of convex lens. What is this f? See, this f is 20.2. okay, means focal length of convex approximate focal length of convex lens is 20.2. now we have to find out this focal length with the help of this convex lens and by the method of displacement method. For this, we are using formula f is equal to d square minus l square upon 4 into d, where f is the focal length of a convex lens, d is the distance between the source and the screen, and l is the distance between the two images, and d is the distance between the source and the screen. Now we have to take capital D, that is the distance between the source and the screen should be greater than 4f. Why the distance between the source and the screen is greater than 4f? 4f a distance ka ghyaycha bara source ani screen madla. Now see, you can observe here, you can get clear image on the real image on this screen. Here distance between source and the lens is twice f, and distance between lens and the screen is twice f, means total will become 4f, means for getting real image of the object, the distance between the source and the screen should be 4f. Therefore, we are taking the readings greater than the distance between the object and the source is greater than 4f. Our focal length of the convex lens is approximately 20. That's why 20 multiplied by 4, we will get here 80. Manje capital D, manje distance between the source and the screen should be greater than 80. Therefore, we are taking reading for the distance 90 centimeter. Now see, distance between the source and the screen is 90 सेंटीमीटर. बघा सोर्स ची मार्किंग केली आहे, त्या मार्किंग पासून आपण हे डिस्टन्स किती घेतलंय, 90 सेंटीमीटर घेतलंय, दॅट इज ग्रेटर दॅन 4f. बघा आता आपण काय करणार आहोत, वी हॅव टू ऑब्टेन मॅग्निफाईड इमेज. जेव्हा आपण स्क्रीनकडे सॉरी जेव्हा आपण लेन्स हा ऑब्जेक्टकडे नेतो त्यावेळेस आपल्याला मॅग्निफाईड इमेज मिळते. बघा तुम्ही मॅग्निफाईड इमेज बघू शकता, ठीक आहे. आता ह्या जेव्हा आपल्याला मॅग्निफाईड इमेज मिळाली, वी हॅव टू मेक पोझिशन ऑफ द स्टँड ऑर पोझिशन ऑफ द मॅग्निफाईड इमेज, त्याला आपण म्हणूया L1, दॅट इज पोझिशन फॉर द मॅग्निफाईड इमेज. अँड ऑल्सो वी हॅव टू टेक ऑर वी हॅव टू मेजर साईज ऑफ द इमेज. वॉट इज द साईज ऑफ द इमेज? इफ वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हिअर, वी विल गेट 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. हिअर 9.8 इज द साईज ऑफ मॅग्निफाईड इमेज, दॅट वी हॅव टू राईट हिअर 9.8. देन अगेन चेंज द पोझिशन ऑफ द लेन्स अँड ऑप्टेन डिमिनिश इमेज. सी हिअर, बाय चेंजिंग द पोझिशन ऑफ द लेन्स वी विल गेट क्लिअर डिमिनिश इमेज. ओके, नाव अगेन फाइंड द साईज ऑफ द डिमिनिश इमेज. वॉट इज द साईज? 1 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम द एरो यू विल सी हिअर 1 सेंटीमीटर
and again 8 millimeter means 1.8 centimeter. You will write here 1.8 centimeter. Also, make the marking for the diminished image, called it as L2, and measure the distance between L1 and L2, that is a capital L, that is the distance between the two position of lenses, that is capital L, and this capital L is 37.5. We will write here 37.5 in the column of distance between the position of the lens. Similar way, we have to take all readings. In this table, you can observe readings are taken. That is, reading for capital D is equal to 100 centimeter. Again, for 110 centimeter, 120 centimeter, 130 centimeter. Means changing distance between the source and screen. For every reading, we have to find out size of the magnified image, also measure the size of diminished image, and also distance between position of lens. Okay, see, all these readings are written in this observation table. Now we move towards the calculation table. See, in this calculation table, first we have to find out d square. D means distance between the source and the screen. D multiplied by d, you will get here values. Again, L multiplied by L, you will get values. Again, next column is of d square minus L square. Again, d square minus L square. Next column is 4 into D, means 4 multiplied by T. Next column, in that column, we have to find out value of F, that is the focal length of convex lens, by the formula D square minus L square divided by 4D. You will get 5 values of focal length of convex lens, that are 18.59, 18.49, 18.76, 18.74, and 18.60. Then we have to find out mean of this F. Add all these values of F and divide it by 5. You will get mean focal length. Next column is D1 multiplied by D2, where D1 is the size of magnified image and D2 is the size of diminished image. Then you will get 5 values. Again, next column is small d, that is size of object, means that filament. Small d is equal to square root of D1 into D2. You will get 5 values: 4.2, 4.56, 4.48, 4.38, and 4.36. These are the values for small d, that is size of object. Again, add these 5 values, divide by 5, you will get mean value of small d, that is size of object. Then, see, these results are: mean F, means focal length of convex lens, is equal to 18.6 centimeter, and mean D, that is size of object, that is equal to 4.4 centimeter.